Right, let's get right into the action now, and the action came fast and furious at Football Park. South, you remember, destroyed Central District 2 weeks ago, played very well against Nord last week. A lot of people suggesting that they're unlucky to lose, and I think I'd agree with that, up against Port Adelaide, and Port has been stung by a lot of criticism of late, so you could expect Port Adelaide to come out with all guns firing today. Let's pick up the action now at the commencement of the last quarter, Port South at Footy Park.
The final quarter at Footy Park, Port Adelaide by 9 points, but the Panthers turn to go with the breeze. At the centre bounce, it's going to be Johnson against Christie. Johnson's tap, Butler can't. An umpire will come in to bounce again. Port have led at every turn, 18 points at quarter time, 2 at half, 9 at 3 quarter. But South had a brilliant first part of that third quarter and got back into the front. Naturally led by 7 points at one stage before the Magpies kicked the goal after the bell, after the siren, to get back in front. Eddie gave it to Brockhurst. Up towards the half forward line, Hutton almost. Leslie pushed in the back, and Martin Leslie gets his free kick. Leslie and Abernethy are interchanging on a half back line and running on the ball. 13th kick, Martin Leslie.
Leslie goes for distance into the breeze. It's a long kick, looking for Smith. Head front spot, but Brockhurst did well from behind. Max City, the crumbs for South Adelaide. We look for Bennett, who was well attended by Johnston. Picked up by Jarvis. Shocking handball, went straight to Leslie. Leslie got a ugly kick forward in the direction of Gary Christie. His handball missed Butler by about 12 foot, going through Abernethy. Did it well, regained his footing, got the kick forward. Off hands now Max Eddy. And Eddy puts the ball back whence it came, and Martin Leslie takes the mark. So footy not good at the moment. Each fighting one another as Boyd takes off from centre wing. Drives long. Darren Smith and Brockhurst. On this occasion, Smith used the body well. Edged Brockhurst out. And Brockhurst, rather stupid football from him, knocking the ball out of Smith's hand. The result, a 15-metre penalty, which now puts Smith well within scoring range. Darren Smith with kick number 13. Played all day at centre half forward. Not a bad kick off the boot either. He's popped it through for his third goal, and Port Adelaide get the first of the final quarter. They're 11-13. They stretch that lead now over South Adelaide on 10-4.
Yes, it was poor defensive work there by Brockhurst, who's done a good job. He got moved into Smith, or onto Smith, after Smith had had a brilliant first quarter, and he's held that player until that time, and then for some unknown reason, he just decided to slap the ball out of his hand. Quite rightly, the umpire gave the 15 metres, and that brought Smith to within shooting distance, and he put on his third goal.
Port Adelaide have been out of the blocks fairly quickly at the start of just about every quarter today, and South Adelaide have slowly hauled their way back into the match. Centre bounce, Johnston against Christie. Johnston won the tap. The handball fed out from Borlase to O'Brien to Harrison. Harrison will have to go and chase the ball again. Handball wasn't good. He's collared by Hewitt. In fact, he's going to be pinged for holding the ball. Good tackle by Darryl Hewitt, been one of South Adelaide's best in defence.
I'd agree with that. He's played very well, 15 kicks. Although he set his teammate up a bit out there, Abernethy on the left leg, wobbles one back, Dickinson. Close, but he got it. Very close to the turf. He'll come out wide looking for Shane Butler. Butler's going to have to work hard. If he gets a decent bounce, he's got easy. Did it well. Butler through the half forward line. Out comes Stasinowski. Umpire looking for a free kick. Well, he's Stasinowski was. The umpire wasn't interested. Now Taylor hooks back. Here's a chance for Stasinowski again. Got a shocking bounce. Phillips playing centre half back this afternoon. Wobbles it back. Butler has to hold ground and take the mark. And the umpire didn't even pay the mark. I cannot believe that. Gee, Butler's in trouble. A very, very poor decision by umpire Schramm.
As Shane Butler was hit very hard in the head there. His mouth guard, in fact, flew out, and he's in plenty of trouble. Umpire must have had his eyes closed. As Delaney drives long, Butler's still in trouble. Mark should be paid to David Kappler. It will be. Kappler with the football on centre wing, grandstand side. Final quarter, the Panthers trail at the moment. High kick. Delaney sandwiched between two Panther players. Christie at the back, it was Steckel at the front. No one on the mark for Port Adelaide. Leslie calling for a play-on decision. Gary Christie will go back for kick number 5. Puts it up high. Players will set themselves. Johnston going with the ball at the back of the pack. Chance for Stasinowski. Hooks around the body. It's a beauty from Stasinowski. Just what South needed. 11 goals for Port Adelaide. 11-13. 4 goals to Stasinowski.
Brilliantly done, Stasinoski. He looked like he'd wasted his opportunity there when he couldn't one grab it. He kicks four. That's his seventh kick and a vital goal to South Adelaide. But Shane Butler, who took that heavy knock, has had to leave the turf. He's just not well at all. And he's going to be replaced by Craig Dewhurst. Tough action here at Footy Park on Sevens Big League. Port Adelaide 11-13, the Panthers 11-4.
9-point break to the Magpies. We approach 5 minutes of the final quarter. Russell Johnston against Christie. Johnston the tap, not effective. Chance now for Abernethy. His kick was smothered off the boot, picked up by Michael Bennett. Wild kick towards centre half forward. Off hands again. It's aerial ping pong at the moment. Coming to meet it was Steckel. Tried to tap it out wide in the direction of Stasinoski. He's working hard for it. He's got to beat three. Now Dewhurst crashes through. The handball fed back now to Max Eddy. Eddie's kick is short. Stasinoski's got room in the pocket. It'll be a great kick if he can kick this one. But he's kicked it out of bounds on the full. It was an awful kick, really, because Ron Taylor was lurking in the square without an opponent on him. Out of bounds on the full. The free kick going the way of Port Adelaide. And it's going to be Scott Hodges.
See, Russell Ebert certainly switched his side round this afternoon. He had Lum starting in the forward pocket. He had, he's got the changes I mentioned of Leslie and Abernethy off the half back line. Whitford up in attack, gets it out to Pittman. That's a good tackle. He's got to be holding the ball. The umpire said holding to him. Well, he ran into it. Pittman, a little fortunate there to get out of it. 11-13 plays, 11-4. Someone's not really happy with the decision. She's got about much chance of changing it as I have. Phillips over the top. Abernethy couldn't. Ball. Tackles on him. Fairclough in. Harrison. Pittman there as well. And the umpire will bounce.
9 points the difference. Played 6.5 minutes of the final quarter. South Adelaide have got Whitford back onto the ground in attack at the moment. Big smash away in the direction of Michael O'Brien. He's strongly tackled by Dickinson. David Kapler in there lending support as well. And umpire Semler will bounce down. South Adelaide with the breeze in this final quarter. Scoring end has definitely been towards the golf course end all day. Phillips from behind, got the tap straight to Abernethy. Hurried kick forward. Players come to meet it. Off plenty of courage shown by John Schneebickler. Took the mark safely on the chest, and kick number 6 coming up for Schneebickler. Had a good duel against Greg Phillips. Good mark 2 to find Steckel. Steckel's a long way out from goals. A good 40 to 45 metres. The breeze from his right to left. Kick number 7 coming up for the South Adelaide full forward. 3 goals so far, 1 in each quarter. He's made the distance all right, he just needs the accuracy. Umpire goes galloping, but it's through for his 4th goal. Great kick by Steckel. South Adelaide get closer. They're 11-12 goals for now. Port Adelaide 11-13.
Gee, he doesn't get many opportunities, this young fellow from Kangaroo Island, but he certainly knows how to kick a footy. He's very accurate. 4 goals is a fine effort at full forward. And South Adelaide now right back in the action. They only trail by 3 points. Plenty of time. 8 minutes gone in the last quarter.
South Adelaide have been very accurate in front of goals. 16 scoring shots for 12-4. Port, on the other hand, 11 goals, 13. Had a shocking third quarter. They kicked 3-8. Oh, a good mark taken by Stasinoski. Here's the player working his way free. He's taken it on the chest only about 30 metres out from goal. Accurate kick here from Stasinoski would put the Panthers back in front. Kick number 9. Plenty of height, plenty of distance. And he speared it straight through the middle. 5 goals to Stasinoski, and South Adelaide put their nose back in front with the breeze. 13-4 they are, Port Adelaide 11-13. South Adelaide players will no doubt be thinking about last week when they spat led Norwood all day and went down on the final siren. They must run this game right out against Port Adelaide. Give the Magpies 1 inch and they'll take a yard. Mark Leslie copped a bit of a corky there too as he hobbles away from the pack. Umpire Semler will bounce again, and Mark Leslie in some discomfort at the moment. Off hands, Fairclough smothered off the boot. Greg Boyd will appear to get one too high. That's the way umpire Semler read it, but he's going to let play go on now. South Adelaide players are caught out of position as Abernethy breaks free, drives in long and finds Russell Johnston. Johnston's only 30 to 40 metres out. He's going to pass off short. Bruce Abernethy, following that play down from the middle of the ground, has taken the mark almost directly in front. Abernethy will take his time. Port Adelaide need this one as a settler. 21 kicks today for Bruce Abernethy. for the Stars to return to the Port Adelaide nest this year. And in and out of form so far. Today they've been very good, and that kick's no exception. He's popped it through for his first goal, and Port Adelaide breathing space. They're back in front again. 12-13, South Adelaide 13-4.
Yes, he's a very classy player. As I said, he's coming off a half-back line, changing on the ball or interchanging with Martin Leslie. Incidentally, the latter doesn't look too good. As Rick said, I think he's got a corky out of that last exchange, and that's not good for South Australia if he can't front next Wednesday night. But Port lead by 3 points.
Seesawing final quarter, lead changing hands consistently. Close games in history, Port Adelaide have come out on top. 15 matches just going through the stat book here, and games won by less than a goal between these two sides. Of those 15, Port Adelaide have won 11 and South 4. A smile or two on the South Adelaide bench, but a long way to go. 11 minute mark, 3 points the difference, Port Adelaide in front. Bennett, an opportunity now for South Adelaide. Eddie shrugs the tackle from Rowan Smith, or the handball to Brockhurst, putting under plenty of pressure. He drives long though. Taylor and Pittman. Taylor front spot. Ron Taylor will take off. Has a look over the shoulder. Sees Stasinoski on a lead. The kick wasn't good. Off hands, Abernethy. Charging through now. Port Adelaide should mop up. Phelps towards centre wing. It's all Panthers though, as Fairclough gets back on it for South Adelaide. Will need some support. Turns back into play. Kicks blindly. Steckel doesn't know where it's gone. Abernethy does. He swoops upon it for the Magpies and drives long towards the centre of the ground. One-on-one duel. Dickinson against O'Brien. Dickinson wins out. Borlase applied the pressure. Anderson used the body well, allowed Smith to pick up. Now John Belton. Belton's got running plays. It's Anderson. Anderson goes in short. Johnston's on a lead. Beautifully put, Greg Anderson, to find the skipper in Russell Johnston. Well, Johnston's slowly getting to his feet. Another South Adelaide player in trouble on the half-back line at the moment too. That's Max Eddy, as we watch Russell Johnston, the skipper of Port Adelaide. Kick number 9 coming up. He's put it out right. The breeze will take it further right, and it's rushed through for a behind. Port Adelaide 12-14, South Adelaide 13-4.
Been a bruising game, top game, 12-13 to 13-4, as Rick said. And it's going to be Brooksby now, goes in short. And he finds Dickinson, who's played pretty well. Hewitt has played very well as he goes looking on the outer side for Stabikler. Pittman's going to have to work hard as well. With him as ball. The ball's still in play, or is it? The umpire ruled that it had gone out, and Pittman is not really happy with the decision, but the umpire always wins. 12-14 to 13-4. Throw in at centre wing. Caught by 4 points. Lum against Christie. Anderson over the top. Gets the roundhouse right in. Dickinson looking for it. Stacks up on the ball, and the umpire will come in and bounce at centre wing.
Desperate final quarter. Conditions have been absolutely magnificent all day. They always are here at Footy Park, but the sun has been out and shining. Crowd certainly enjoying this game. It's set for a great finish. Kapler against Bald. Kapler worrying Bald, and he just dribbles the ball over the boundary line for the throw-in. Colin Bald getting his chance in the league side today. Tim Ginever pulling out of the squad for Port. Throw-in out of sight. 13 minutes gone. Port Adelaide by 4 points. Craig Lum, taken now by John Belton, another newcomer for Port Adelaide. First league game today, Smith and Brockhurst. Brockhurst up high, over the back of Smith, but Smith's been called to play on. Now a big chance for Borlase, hooks around the body, falls in no man's territory. Johnston comes to meet it, feeds out the handball to Rowan Smith, and Smith didn't really take his time. He was under extreme pressure, and the kick's offline and through for a point. 12-14 now, Port. South Adelaide 13-4.
Yes, they've had their chances to be a lot further in front. 3-8 in the third quarter didn't help them, but they're fighting on well, and they've got a 5-point lead now. The umpire has seen a free kick. It's going the way of Stabikler. Stabikler's almost at centre-half back when he takes. Looking for a running par. Kick number 7. Screws a long ball half-forward line. It's going to be a loose one, or is it? No, getting across is Harrison, who gets back at centre-half back to take the mark. Harrison could have been moved. He doesn't appear to be at centre wing anymore, although he's been back shooting at goal as well. He covers plenty of ground. Kick number 10 towards centre wing. With him, Dewhurst. But it's well taken by Abernethy. Perhaps as good as any Port Adelaide player this afternoon. It's his 23rd kick. He has played well. Belton can't quite get it. With him there, Fairclough. Players pile up. And umpire Semler will come in and bounce.
The torrid football at the moment. 5 points the difference. Port Adelaide in front. Christie goes for the safety of the line. Rowan Smith chases the ball for Port Adelaide. and the result will be a boundary throw-in. Well, Adelaide in front at the moment by 5 points, but twice in this game, South Adelaide have come back to snare the lead. Offhand, Smith, clever tap out to John Belton, a super smother off the ball by Faircloak. Board working hard for it, doesn't keep it in bounds, and the throw-in in the half-forward line there for Port Adelaide into the breeze in this final quarter.
12-15 plays, 13-4. It's going to be a tough last 15 minutes. Smith, the bottom of the pack there is Dewhurst. Dewhurst again, Kepler hasn't got it. Faircloak through, the umpire's seen a free kick. And Faircloak is going to give it back now to Kepler on the half-back line for being held when not in possession. South Adelaide off their half-back line, kick number 15, Kepler. Goes towards half-forward line. Steckler's out there on the half-forward line at the moment. Phillips back in defence. Tries to get it back. Did it well to Hutton. Out wide and still is young Belton. He's been a useful performer in his first game. Drives long up towards Hewitt. Within there is Bald. Bald has gone from back to forward pocket, but on that occasion he thumps the ball out of play.
8,500 people today at Football Park for the game between Port and South, and they're witnessing a thriller at the moment. Port have their nose in front. Chance for South Adelaide in Eddie. He taps it wide, but Belton's first there for Port Adelaide. Belton has a look, sees the lead coming. It's a strong one too from Darryl Borlase, and Borlase has it in the centre of the ground. Off goes Johnston. Ignored by Borlase. High ball. Hewitt needs support. He's got Whitford running for him. This is Whitford now. The handball to Michael Bennett. He'll draw the player. Tried to work it towards Brockhurst, but Rowan Smith was quickly on the scene. Also in there now is Boyd to Smith. This is Rowan Smith from the left forward pocket. He'll take a great kick, goes across the face of goals. Players set themselves, and it's going to result in a boundary throw-in in the right forward pocket for Port Adelaide. They've been doing most of the attacking in the last 5 minutes. We've played 17 minutes of the final quarter.
Yes, Rick, I don't think the wind is of any consequence now. Here's a chance. Michael O'Brien shoots for goal. I think that's a magnificent kick. Johnson can't find it. He's out there with it now, looking to pass off. Beautifully done, Brooksby. Quickly in Belton. On goes the saddle. Diving on it. Borlase. This way, that away. Hooks back. And the umpire said he's well offline for a point. But that takes the Magpies 6 points clear. South will need a goal plus to win it. But there's plenty of time at the 17-minute mark.
Some pretty desperate work in defence by South Adelaide. Will Brooksby on that occasion really giving it his all. He's the player to bring the ball back into play. Goes directly down the centre of the ground. A booming kick out too. Smith had front spot, got caught underneath the ball. Bennett off hands. Had to get rid of it. He was going to the ground. Strong tackle applied by Leslie. In turn, Whitford will find Dewhurst. Dewhurst having trouble. Phillips is right with him. And Phillips has given away the free kick. Well, a heart-stopping finish coming up as Dewhurst drives the Panthers long into attack. All the mark almost paid. Hodges from behind. He's the player with the use of the footy. Works it out towards Baker. And his kick will go back, straight back in the arms of Craig Dewhurst. Dewhurst doesn't kick a long ball normally. Kick underway. Steckle front spot. Stasanowski off hands. He'll have a shot at goal. It's coming back. It's a beautiful goal, Stasanowski. What an absolute ripper. 6 goals to South win. He's a match winner. South Adelaide 14-4. Port Adelaide 12-16.
Gone of the final quarter. Anyone's game here at Football Park. Port against South. Abernethy, Dewhurst, the two number fives holding on. Decision going the way of Bruce Abernethy. Well, Abernethy with the experience for Port Adelaide. He's done had 24 kicks today, Bruce Abernethy. If Port lose this, it's through no fault of his. Brooksby again doing well in defence, but swooping on it very quickly is Darryl Borlase. Finds himself a metre or two, drives in long to the square at the back of the pack. Brockhurst, no, it wasn't Brockhurst. It was Michael Whitford back there for South Adelaide. And boy, is he covering some territory. He was in attack about 5 minutes ago. Now he's taking marks in the last line of defence. High kick out to find Brooksby, and Brooksby will settle it down for South Adelaide.
Brooksby played well again. Had a torrid first quarter. Kick number 8 coming up, but he's always so cool, calm and collected. Dreisler's to Bickler. The big leap in front there was Steckel. Off the fingers, Eddie. Coming to meet it now. Harrison obviously playing in defence at the second grab. He takes it. And, gee, do you think Russell Ebert has taken any, 15 metres, has made any moves here? He shuffled them everywhere. Kick number 11, Harrison, through the centre line. Go Port Adelaide up towards the half-forward line. Hewitt there. Johnson at the back now. Smith needs to pass off. Can't find it. Coming through Hewitt. Off the side of his boot. Borg with a chance. And he's taken a fine mark. Showed a little bit of courage. Had to go hard for the footy, and he's won it. Might be too far out to score. He thought about Anderson, but now he's going in longer for Johnson. Not going to find that player. Whitford back in defence, and he'll get the free kick rather than the mark. The umpire's paid a push in the back, and the free kick will go to Michael Whitford, almost on the goal line.
Free kick was definitely there to Whitford. He did well, held his ground. He drives long towards the outer side, looking for David Dickinson against O'Brien. Dickinson's got pace, but so is O'Brien. O'Brien's well on his hammer. Anderson trying to lend support for Port Adelaide. He's the player that comes out with the footy. Drives long, up towards centre half forward. Players set themselves. Johnston front spot. Off hands now. Borlase comes out with the footy. Left foot kick is high. Only covers about 20 metres. Smith's underneath it for Port Adelaide, as well as Tylor. Borlase again. Now Jarvis, all a little slow. Sandwich between Belton and the other opponent as Boyd picks up for Port Adelaide and drives in long towards goals. And Greg Boyd, out of all that, Schmeichel has come out with his first goal. Port Adelaide 13 goals, 16. South Adelaide 14-4.
Well, Boyd's been playing centre wing this afternoon. We found it hard to pick him up for a while there. He's covering so much ground. His first three shots for goal were ineffective. In fact, they all missed. But at the time Port Adelaide needed him, he came out of the pack there, dropped it onto his boot quickly, and he's got his first and Port Adelaide's 13th. They lead 13-16 to 14-4 on Sevens Big League.
21 and a half minutes gone of the final quarter. Centre bounce. Lum against Christie. Maybe Christie the knock. Rowan Smith was clean bowled. Belton is likewise. Kapler tackled by Borlase. Anderson breaks free for Port Adelaide. He's normally a great kicker of the footy. A well done Whitford in defence. Got a hand of the footy and saw it through for a rush behind. Port Adelaide 13-17. They stretch the lead. South Adelaide 14-4.
Yeah, Port Adelaide on a roll at the moment. South would score against the trend. Port have been doing most of the attacking in this final quarter. Brooksby heaves the ball back in towards the half-back line. Dunk forward. Jarvis back in defence. Gets the kick away. Now South are falling down across their half-forward line at the moment. Loose ball. Pittman there. Back there with him, Hutton. Supported on the outer side by Abernethy. He's got time to have two bounces. Three bounces. Kick number 25 goes to the half-forward line by Mark Borlase. Rips it out quickly now, ball. Port Adelaide going to attack. Tyler can't. Brooksby again, close to the line. Tyler does it well, wants running support. Gets it there, Borlase in towards full forward. Michael Bennett gets bowled. Rowan Smith in. He needs support. Russell Johnson, the big man, does it well. Boots the goal, and that could be game, set, and match. His first. A beautiful ball by the big fellow. And Port Adelaide have got number 14 on the board. 14-17, 14-4 on Sevens Big League. Have got to get up off their knees now and get back into this game. Lum on the ball, gets the tap away. Kapler through, can't find the footy. Fairclough hasn't got it either. Christie loses it, whips out the handball. Bennett now, bowled for the second time in a minute. Anderson through, working hard now, he's lost the footy. Steckel with a chance, dummies the handball, the big fellow's done it well. Puts out the pass now, it's the pick that's got to make a meter, can't find it. Quickly Eddie raising a gallop. Dummies, out of trouble or is he? Puts out the pass. Dewhurst has got it on the half-forward line. South in attack, but down by 13 points. Kapler wants it. Kick number 8, Dewhurst. He puts it up now. Out comes Dabrowski. Can't get up there. He got up there, couldn't bring it down. Harrison through. In goes Pittman. Players going in hard. And the umpire will come and bounce on South's half-forward line.
Approaching full time of the final quarter. Port Adelaide in front at the moment. Plenty of goals kicked though in this final quarter. 4 to Port and 4 to South Adelaide. So time on the board. If South Adelaide can haul themselves back into this game once again, they've been doing it all day. Lum and Phillips up high for Port Adelaide. And players will bottle that ball up once again. And umpire Semler to bounce down. Port Adelaide 14-17. South Adelaide 14-4. Two vital premiership points up for grabs here. Tap out in the direction of Kapler. Anderson in there strongly for Port Adelaide, as well as Lum. and umpire Semler will repeat the bounce.
The Magpies by 13 points and we're into time on final quarter. South desperately need a goal. They've got to get one while it's in their offensive position. Here's a chance now. Stasinowski on the left leg. Oh, beautifully smothered. He butters up again. He could get pink for holding the ball. He gets it out. Kepler through. Can't get the ball to his boot. In there's Leslie. Big Baker lumbers underneath the ball. He's going to, after the ball, he's going to need help from there. Down he goes. And the umpire said, play on. And the ball goes out of play in the full forward left pocket. Caught by 13 points.
Stasinowski had a big chance there. It's caught in two minds. Throw in. Baker got up high, as did Lum. Steckel spooled off the boot. Craig Lum in for Port Adelaide. Very close to the boundary line. In fact, he's been ruled out. And a throw-in will result again. So South Adelaide have the ball in their attack zone. They need a goal desperately. They trail at the moment. We're into time on.
Do they ever need one? They need a couple. In actual fact, if they want to win the game. But they've got to score here. Port Adelaide through Hutton. Does it well. Drives long out towards the half-back. Here's Brockhurst now, puts it up. Stasinowski, great marker, is it? The umpire says play on. Stasinowski at the bottom of the pack, has to bail it out. In trouble there is Eddie. Players go in hard. Pittman can't find it. In there's Anderson. Gee, do you think they're throwing themselves in on the footy now? And the umpire letting play go. Oh, what a scramble. And the umpire's going to come in and bounce right now. And players are trying their hearts out there, I can tell you.
Chris Stasinowski can count himself unlucky. Thought he had a good portion of that football, not paid the mark. Umpire Semler the bounce. Christie from the side. Leslie, a hurried kick. The side of the boot. Michael Bennett maybe first there for South Adelaide with Eddie. Greg Boyd going in hard for Port Adelaide. And umpire Semler will bounce against. And the Port Adelaide defence holding up at the moment. South Adelaide desperately need a goal. 1 minute already gone of time on. Make that two.
Yes, time running out for the Panthers now. Anderson, geez, played well under pressure. Burton, like this young fellow, kicks long, flat enough, he got rid of the ball. Bad football by Taylor. Port Adelaide running on Hutton now. Smothered Wells, the Bickler at charge, can't quite fight it. Tyler there, the tackle's high. Umpire not interested, and he's coming into bounce once more. But Port Adelaide have successfully bottled up the game. South can't get it through their half forward line, and the Magpies look like running out now. Winners leading by 13 points.
But over 27 minutes, Darren Smith. They won't give up, South Adelaide. Looks as though they're going to repeat their rather sad effort of last week when they had Norwood on toast and went down by a kick almost on the final siren. And today, Port Adelaide have just edged them out over the concluding stages. Max Eddie drives long. Christie front spot, spawned away by Lund. Hodges first on the scene for Port Adelaide. Crashes through three Panther players. Leslie still able to raise a gallop. Took a heavy knock in this quarter. Fed out the handball to Boyd, good work. In turn, Colin Ball. Ball drives long up to the left forward pocket. Hewitt's there with Belton. Belton at the back of the pack. This is John Belton, if he can pick it up. The fact the whistle is gone. And Belton will be asked to come all the way back with the footy. And the free kick will go the way of South Adelaide and Darryl Hewitt.
Hewitt out of the back pocket. Davies showing the concern now. Phillips thumps clear. Anderson jams it onto his boot. Rowan Smith. Port Adelaide have steady. They say don't play on quickly, but making the pace now is Abernethy. Elects to play on, goes on the left foot, chips away at goal, and he's just got it offline. But I think you can put your glasses down. We've played 29 minutes, and Port Adelaide playing far the better now, lead by 14 points.
Brooksby down the centre of the ground. Christie and Lum up high, scored away from behind. Taken by Bennett. Now David Kapler. Kapler works onto the left boot. He's got a player loose out wide. This is Mark Pittman. Pittman in turn will find Dewhurst. Abernethy closing very quickly. Good tackle, Abernethy, on Dewhurst. Allows Port Adelaide to rebound again as Harrison goes right across the ground. Big chase is on now as the ball dribbles its way towards the boundary line. And Greg Boyd will see it safely out. He doesn't mind. Time is on Port Adelaide's side. They're 14-18, South 14-4.
Eddie trying to run with cramp. He looked like a man with a wooden leg at that stage. Christie gets the tap away cleverly. Steckel, Stasinowski, oh, took the mark. The umpire said play on. Right forward pocket, he goes in with a long one. He put another one through. Oh, what a brilliant goal. Number seven. South still in there fighting at the 29-minute mark, 15-4. They trail the Magpies 14-18 on Seven's big lead.
The word it's really failed me for Chris Dasanoski today. He's kicked 7 goals. I'd imagine that 5 of those have come from some unbelievably acute angles. He's made them look all so casual. 11 kicks in South Adelaide. Well, still a glimmer of hope, but they still need 2 goals. They trail at the moment by some 8 points.
At the centre bounce. 8 points to difference. 30 minutes gone, so imminent. At the bounce, it's going to be Christie against Lum, who got the tap away. Fair close through. It's the Bickler over the top. At the bottom of the pack is Lum, and the umpire will rebounce the footy. Umpire Stephen Semler. At the centre bounce, it's almost back in the circle, as you can see. 30 minutes gone. It's a long quarter, but as Rick told you, there's been a lot of goals this quarter. Port Adelaide a chance to go into attack. Michael O'Brien through the half-forward line. Jarvis can't catch him. Puts in a long one, but he's offline, searching for it as Whitford, and he takes the ball in the back pocket.
Michael Whitford with the footy. South needed into attack, and they need it quickly. In fact, there goes the final siren. Port Adelaide have run out winners over South Adelaide today here at Football Park. The final scoreline, Port Adelaide, 14 goals, 18, 102 points. South Adelaide, 15 goals for 94. And, well, I imagine coach Rick Davies would be bitterly disappointed again. Saw his side lose to Norwood last week, and they've gone down to Port Adelaide here at Football Park.
Yes, one must feel a bit sorry for Rick Davies. South getting close, but of course getting close does not win premiership points. Port Adelaide, an 8-point victory there over South Adelaide. Darren Smith and Lum booted 3 for the Magpies. Stasanovski, an outstanding performance with 7. Stokel is still booting them. He got 4, and Pittman got 3 for South Adelaide. After the game, Daisy Day caught up with Port Adelaide coach Russell Ebert.
Russell, I don't think I've ever seen you make so many moves. I was going giddy trying to keep up.
Yeah, I think I was too, Ian, but losing Michael Airy in the first quarter really sort of upset the whole balance of it, and then Martin Leslie got a knock, and so I had to throw the side around because a couple of their players were kicking goals, and so you can't just let them keep kicking goals, so I had to make moves.
Craig Lum looked like to be a good move, sticking him up forward there and rather than resting him on the bench. Kicked a few goals for you early.
Yes, well, Lummy's a really honest lad, and that's the way he plays his football, and wherever I put him, he'll do his utmost, and he showed that today. Not only the goals he scored himself, but I think he was responsible probably for 3 or 4 others. But I thought Mark Todd also at full forward worked hard, although the scoreboard won't show it. He did a lot of scrounging work too.
A little unusual changing Leslie and Abernethy off the half-back flank.
Is that where they were they?
Well, I tried to work it out.
That one up. Yeah, that's a well picked up, Ian. Oh, yeah, well, they both played in defence, and they're both ball-getting players, so I want my good players around the ball as long as I can, and that was one way of getting them there.
Were you happy?
Happy to get the 2 points.
Thanks, Russell.
Thanks, Ian.
Yeah, well, Daisy's no fool. He knew where Abernethy and Martin Leslie were changing. It was at half-back. That is a bit unusual, but Russell Ebert certainly made a lot of moves today. Smith centre-half forward, Tyler full forward. Greg Phillips did play at centre-half back today too. Not because of anything that commentators or media people have had to say, but that's where Russell wants to play him. He can play at centre-half back. I think he can play in most spots. But Ian Day used to be an ex-Panther, having played for South Adelaide in their premiership days. In fact, 1964, he was a little rover for them. And he had this today to say about his old side, South Adelaide.
South Adelaide simply don't know how to win. That's the second game in 2 weeks that has been close and they have lost. But the trouble is that with South in the last quarter, when the going starts to get tough, some of their players simply fade out of the game. In the last quarter, it was about 2 or 3 players only that kept them in it. Stasanovski was one with his 3 fantastic goals. But South Adelaide is simply going to learn how to win.
Yeah, well, that's pretty hard to learn how to win, isn't it, really? But South... one player I want to talk to you about, Stasanovski. You called him a goal-kicking genius at the start of the year, and that stuck with him. But you made a comment off-air, and I think it was a good one. He manufactures goals, doesn't he?
Well, that's right, Pete. For whatever reason, when Chris plays a game of league football, he just finds the goals. On a bad day, he picks up his 2 or 3, and on a good day, as I saw, 7 today, I think 4 and 1/4. But you can't argue that Port shouldn't have won the game, Pete. They had 32 shots to 19. Mm. And, you know, South would have been a mite lucky to have got the 2 points. Nonetheless, they're not far away. That's obvious. They've run Norwood, who are the top side, equal top side at the moment, to 4 points last week. They've run Port to 8 points, was it today? Right. I mean, it's heartbreaking, but they're going through, a building period where this is going to happen more times than it won't. All of a sudden, they killed Central 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Yes, and had a good victory against Torrens earlier
in the year. Exactly, and, you know, they've just got to hang in there because it's so depressing, I know. but they're not that far away, and I just feel that justice might be done over the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, I hope you're right, because the way the ladder is set up at the moment, you win three or four on end and suddenly you're in business again. So South Adelaide not far away. Stay with us, the game from Glenelg Oval right after the break.